Okay, a little reminder, the purpose of this channel is not to show you final products, but directly straight out of camera, so that you can see what the specific lenses and camera settings can do. Whatever you do in Photoshop, that's totally your business after that, right? Somebody could, you know, modify this picture according to his own taste. You know, for example, some people want it I don't know, a little more like that, you know, I don't know, or like this, or even like this, you know, I don't know. So it really depends on the personal taste of somebody. Now it's horrible. I like it the way I shot it, like this. Now if I want a little here, zero, everything to zero. So in the spirit of this, I'm just gonna show you it's not really a thorough test or anything. I'm gonna show you some shots from last year of the Gerlitz Orestor 135, the Nikon 135 AIS f2.8, an absolutely wonderful lens for its size and cost, and all that compared with the Milvus 135. So I took these pictures, and this is with the Gerlitz Orestor. This is with the Nikon 135 at 5.6, and this is with the Milvus 135. Now at first look, of course, they all look, oh, it's the same picture. Well, it's not. I mean, look at the color of this car first. Look at it with a Nikon, and look at it here with a Milvus. The Milvus has the most realistic rendering of this area here, and the same goes for the greens too. The Orestor here seems to slightly colorize everything a little on the orange side. Otherwise, it's a nice lens, and it actually has a gazillion aperture blades, so it's gonna give you amazing bokeh. Bokeh balls at night, especially. So it's a nice lens, and if you like antique lenses, it's one of the best. Now, as far as the Nikon compared to the Milvus, here's a detail I want you to look here: how this little tree stands out from the rest of its environment, while with a Nikon, okay, the focus point is almost at the same level. It's not exactly the same with the Milvus. It's a little more in focus, but still with the Milvus it looks better separated from the rest. This is again the Milvus. Now look at the tree and the car, how separated they look here, a little more embedded here. Let's look at individual branches. This is with the Milvus, how they are separated from each other, and this is with the Nikon. Now these are just, you know, initial impressions, and one has to study the behavior of a lens over a series of different environments to determine things, but generally speaking it seems that the Milvus looks to capture color more accurately compared to the Nikon. Let's get them at the same size here. This is the Nikon, this is the Milvus. The Milvus is far more dimensional than the Nikon. However, let's consider that the Nikon is 1/3 of its size and 1/10 of its cost. You can get this wonderful Nikon lens, this is the Nikon picture, for like $200 in excellent condition. It's very small, light, portable. It's got this retractable lens hood up front, and I think you're going to enjoy it a lot. The Milvus is a big, heavy, very expensive lens, and if anything gets decentered in the Milvus, trust me, you're gonna notice it. Now let's go on the roof pictures. This is with the Orestor. This is the Milvus. No, this is the Orestor, sorry. This is the Milvus, and this is the Nikon. All right. The first thing that I notice, you see this cable here? Usually this is the area, the white cable, that I see a lot of chromatic aberrations. In this case, they're not many. They're rather well controlled. This is the Milbus. Let's compare the cable in both. Both images were focused here. All the images, I focused them here on that little label. The Milbus has better chromatic aberration control at 5.6. However, I gotta tell you about this lens, and this is again not a thorough test of any of these lenses. The Milbus 135 tends to have stronger aberrations, wide open, fringing, not aberrations, fringing. So you have to close it down a little bit, but when you close them down, look at this thing here. See, it's much more clean with the Milbus. Now, of course, the Milbus 135 is an exceptionally expensive lens, and heavy and big, as I said before. Now, as far as the Orestor, which is an ancient lens, very old lens, it's doing a fantastically good job. Still, though, the Nikon is doing a better job than the Orestor. This is the Nikon, this is the Orestor. The Nikon is doing an overall better job than the Orestor, and it's half the size of the Orestor and half the cost of the used lenses you can get on eBay. So if you're traveling around and you want one 135mm prime, personally I would take the Nikon any day, because the Zeiss is an obnoxiously heavy beast. Of course, with the Milbus 135, let's check it, compare it with the Nikon, and this is the best I could get with a Nikon. Painstakingly careful with the focusing. Yeah, the Zeiss is a little better, okay. But the Zeiss is over $2,000, the Nikon is $200. This is the Nikon, this is the Zeiss, and this is the Orestor. Not bad for the Orestor, huh? For these old lens. And I do not see any funny artifacts that appear usually in these areas. I mean, they're very minimal. As a matter of fact, the Nikon has a little better performance. Look at how clean the lines are compared to the Milbus, which seems to be allowing some coloration in between the lines, which appear here in the Nikon, not much though, in the blurry area, so to speak, right? The Orestor is exceptionally clean, as a matter of fact, as I see here, but not as sharp. So, to make your selection now, as I said, for a 135 lens, a small manual lens that I could put in a pocket, it's a pocket size lens, I would take the Nikon 135 2.8, I think it's 2.8 or 2, I don't remember now, any day over the Milbus or anything like that for travel, because it's small, portable, light, and it produces exceptional images. These are all, as I said before, straight out of camera. Okay, again here the Gerlitz Orestor, which adds this annoying coloration that I cannot really tolerate in daylight. This is the Nikon, very good color, excellent reproduction, decent dimensionality. Of course, the Milbus is better in all aspects, but big, heavy, expensive. Thanks a lot, bye.